BC TV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Good evening, and welcome to the Berks Arts Council program tonight on BC TV. My name is Meggan Kerber, and I am the Executive Director of the Berks Arts Council. Tonight, we are pleased to feature the Reading Blues Fest as our feature story. Tonight, we have with us John Ernesto, the General Manager. Welcome, John.
Hi, Meggan. How you doing?
Great.
Good. Great to be here.
Good. So glad to have you here. Our show this year will feature... will be featured from November 16th through the 18th at the Doubletree. But before we get into this year's Blues Fest, can you tell us a little bit about how Blues Fest came about here in Reading?
Sure. I'm a member of the Berks County Civic Center Authority Board and Convention Center Authority, not Civic Convention Center Authority. Anyways, Albert Bosco, who's very involved, obviously, with the Jazz Festival, he was talking to me one day about trying to create an event, another event like Jazz Fest, to help promote the city of Reading. So anyway, so we came up with the idea of featuring blues, and he gave his thumbs up to it, and we started working on it. Unfortunately, Albert passed before the first one took place, but we still managed to make it happen. And last year we did a first one, and it was a success. So we learned a lot, and we made some changes to the event this year to make it a little more easy for fans. Everything's going to be at the Doubletree this year.
Great.
So all the shows, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, are going to be at the Doubletree. We're utilizing the big, the grand ballroom, the small ballroom, and the amphitheater.
Great.
So it's going to be a great 3 days of music. It's very diverse, a lot of interesting programming, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
Awesome. So what else did we learn from our first year of things that we are doing a little bit differently this year?
Well, one thing we by having it all in one place, it was enabling us to create what we call all-day tickets. Instead of having ticket pricing for each show, now a fan can buy a ticket for the whole day and see everything that day. For instance, on Friday night, we kick off with Booker T and Ruthie Foster. We have an opening night concert with Craig Thatcher and G.E. Smith, and there's a late night show with Craig Thatcher and G.E. Smith, a jam session. So for one ticket price, which is $59, you get a whole evening of music. And then like Saturday night, the all-day ticket price is $79, and the music events start at 10 a.m. and run till like 1 a.m., so you get to see a lot of entertainment. And on Sunday, we have a film in the morning, and we have a big finale, which is four concerts in the afternoon. So, and then you can get the whole thing for $175, a VIP package. So you can get the whole weekend of music for $175, see all this music without leaving the Doubletree.
It's incredible, one, that's one at the Doubletree.
Right.
And we're able to utilize that entire facility.
Yeah.
But the ticket price is extremely reasonable. A lot of times, if you're a great concert goer out there, you can't even do one concert for $59 or $79, and here you're getting a full day worth of amazing artists coming to Reading.
We've taken the same philosophy that we had with the Jazz Festival, is we try to make it affordable for the fans. We want fans to come for more than one day or see one show. We want them to experience the whole weekend and come and have a good time. We've even programmed time for people to go downtown for dinners and things in between shows. So, yeah, it is very affordable based on if you go to some tickets today or crazy money.
Crazy money.
And we try to make it affordable, and hopefully people will come and participate, have fun for all 3 days.
And I understand the VIP tickets, great package, only about 24 left?
Yeah, it's just getting to the end. We have a limit, and... So if you're interested in getting a VIP package, I suggest you go to ReadingBluesFest.com and
get your tickets,
or go to the box office at the the Santander Arena and get your tickets, get your VIP tickets. It's $175. It's a great deal for
great
all
deal.
That music.
So. Yeah, 3 days of music, you can't beat it for $175.
And the reaction to the VIP tickets has been pretty amazing so far.
Yes, they've sold very quickly.
Yeah.
I get only 24 left.
Yeah.
So if you want to come all 3 days, it's your best deal. Make sure you get your tickets today. So let's kind of go back and looking at some of our concerts. Friday, we are starting our welcome concert at 6 p.m. with Craig Thatcher. And then our biggest concert of that night is Booker T. Jones. Do you want to tell us a little bit about those?
Sure. We were looking for something different to do opening night. So we were fortunate enough to have an opportunity to book Booker T. Jones from the legendary Booker T. and the MGs. And we paired him with Ruthie Foster, and she's going to do her own show. But for Ruthie's show, we've added the Doxal Gospel Ensemble. Ruthie, in addition to do blues, she does a lot of gospel music. So she's going to, it's like two or three songs that the choir is actually, the gospel ensemble is going to sing with her. So, but Booker T's, I'm excited to see Booker T here, and that's going to be a great way to kick off the weekend.
Absolutely.
So.
I think I have goosebumps already from knowing that he's coming to town.
I mean, he's a legend in the music, whether it's jazz, blues, just a music legend. So.
Absolutely. Shall we introduce our guest to Booker T?
Absolutely. We have a great film, a great video here of Booker T performing at Darryl's place, you know, Darryl Hall from Hall & Oates. And this is Booker T playing the classic Green Onions.
Green Onions. So here we go.
Brian Dunn, Darryl Hall, me and Thank you.
Awesome, John.
That was good.
That was just awesome. Looking forward to having them in town.
It'd be great if we get Daryl Hall to come, too.
Oh, my gosh. Totally would love that. We'd love to have Daryl Hall come. Maybe he'll just surprise us with his appearance. Yeah. But Friday, I wanted to mention as well, we are definitely having our concerts that kick off at 6 o'clock. But over lunchtime, we have a special kickoff luncheon at the Peanut Bar with the Blues Masters. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about who's going to be featured with the Blues Masters.
Well, you know, if you're familiar with the Berks Jazz Fest forever, it's the tradition as the kickoff luncheon is Friday around 11:30, and it's always been the Groove Masters, Benny Sims and Cliff and David Collin and everyone. So when we came out with the Blues Fest, I said to Michael Leifer and I were talking one day, and I said, we got to do a kickoff luncheon. So anyway, we got on a phone call Benny and said, do you want to change the name to the Blues Masters for a day? So, and he said, yes. Yeah. So that's how we got the same thing going that we do for Jazz Fest. So it's just a little, you know, and the Eric Wallace sits in on it and some other people. It's a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun last year.
It's going to be a great time. I know that if you want to go to this, you have to call now and make reservations. Yeah, yeah. People have been lining up, and it's literally going to be standing room only.
It's always jammed.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting. Yeah. So on Saturday, we're going to have Blind Boy Paxton. Mm-hmm. He's going to be doing two shows. Noon and 6 p.m.
Yep.
And we're also going to have Chicago Plays the Stones with Ronnie Baker Brooks, which is sweet.
That's a new project that the record's just coming out. It's all these Chicago blues guys are doing the music of the Rolling Stones. You know, the Stones were very influenced by the old Chicago blues masters. And so they decided to do this project. And actually, it was supposed to come out earlier this year, but Mick Jagger and Keith Richards heard about it. They listened to some of the stuff, so they wanted to play on it. So they had to go back in the studio and recut some songs.
Okay.
And then, so if you go to get the record, Keith Richards and Mick Jagger are on this record.
And that comes out this week?
I believe it's this week or next week at the latest. But it's called Chicago Plays the Stones, and it's we're one of the first shows of this touring group, and Billy Branch and Ronnie Baker Brooks are headlining with their friends, a bunch of guys from Chicago blues world, and I'm really looking forward to it. Ronnie Baker Brooks is an outstanding entertainer.
Absolutely.
He's been here several times playing Building 24 and some other venues, so he's a great guy.
Yeah. I think we have a sample of their music as
well. Yeah, we have an audio of Chicago Plays of Ronnie Baker Brooks playing Satisfaction.
All right, let's try this out.
I can't get no satisfaction. I can't get no satisfaction, y'all. 'Cause I tried, and I tried, I tried. Supposed to fire my imagination. I can't get no, 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 no. Hey, 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 that's what I say. I can't get no satisfaction, y'all. I can't get no satisfaction. 'Cause I tried, I tried, I tried, tried, tried. I can't get no, I can't get no. When I'm watching my TV and that man comes on to tell me how white my shirt can be, but he can't be a man 'cause it doesn't smoke the same kind of reefer as me. I can't get no, 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 no. Hey, 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 that's what
satisfaction I can't get no girl reaction. Cause I tried and I tried, I tried, tried and tried. To see I'm on a losing streak. I can't get no, 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 no satisfaction, a satisfaction. I can't get no a satisfaction.
John, our guests are going to be pretty pumped up come the afternoon yeah. listening to that. And then at the nighttime, we have Tommy Castro and the Painkillers coming in, plus Tinsley Ellis.
Yeah, it's a great double bill, two real great guitar slingers, and it's going to be a fantastic show. Then we move from there to the Blues Jam, hosted by Vanessa Collier in the evening.
So we're going to go all night long.
Yeah, it's going to be a full day on Saturday, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to it. Yeah.
And then we're getting up extra early
on
in the
Sunday morning.
We might just stay up all night because we have the great film screening of Sidemen.
Yeah, it's an outstanding documentary of legendary blues side guys, Sidemen, who play with all the legends, Muddy Waters. And I've seen this documentary, and it's really very well done. The gentleman who directed the documentary is going to be here to have a post screening Q&A about it, so that should be a lot of fun. And then we go into our
big finale.
We have four concerts in our finale. It kicks off with Vanessa Collier and her band. Then we have Jazz Gets the Blues with Clarence Spady and Berks Jazz Fest favorite Nicole Leone. And then we go to the John Nemeth and the Blue Dreamers, and the Berks Horns, Mike Anderson and the Berks Horns mm-hmm. are going to be playing with them. Then we wrap it all up with Shamika Copeland. So you have a full day of music. Starts at noon, and it will end at around 7 o'clock on Sunday. So you can get home and get ready for work the next day. But it's going to be, I'm really excited about the festival, and obviously the Arts Council and everyone, we're hoping that people come out and support it so we can keep it going.
Absolutely, yeah. It's going to be an amazing weekend. We're probably going to be exhausted by Sunday at 7, probably crawling back home, but it's definitely going to be worth it.
Yeah.
And in addition to the main concerts, I mentioned earlier that we're going to be at the Peanut Bar kicking off with the luncheon on Friday. But we also have some concerts going on at Sofrito and the Goggle Works. So please make sure you check out our full schedule at readingbluesfest.com because you can also go to those events and activities that are being held by some of our local restaurants. Again, our tickets, our VIP tickets are selling out. So forget to get it. Only 24 left of 200. And then we have plenty of our daily show tickets. So if you say, hey, I can't come for the whole weekend, but I'd love to be there Saturday or Sunday, you can get your daily tickets and enjoy the show. Before we close, I want to thank you for being with us tonight. We're super excited.
I just want to welcome you to the craziness of Blues Fest and Jazz Fest.
Thank you. Yeah. We hit the floor running when we start as a new executive director. Yeah. We never slow down. So we absolutely love this opportunity. Please, if you're not following us at readingbluesfest.com or our Facebook page, please do so. But before we sign off, I think we have about another minute or so left. Why don't we put in a quick plug-in for our holiday show? What can our guests expect for that this year?
The holiday show will be Sunday, December the 2nd, and it's Peter White Christmas with Rick Braun and Huge Groove. Last year it was Keiko Matsui in a different show, but we come back to our traditional event with Peter White and Rick Braun and Huge Groove, and there's two shows, 3 o'clock and 7 o'clock, and it's you know, it's Christmas music. It's a mix of Christmas music and regular and traditional jazz and stuff, but they do such a great job, and people plan every year to go to this mm-hmm. thing, and I say to them, "Do you get tired of seeing this?" And they say, "No, it's a tradition. We love it. It's a great day. It's a great afternoon. A great evening." So, Berks Jazz Fest annual holiday show is something I encourage everyone to come out and support. It's at the Miller Center, mm-hmm. one of the finest places to watch live music, and.
You want to get your tickets today.
Yeah,
tickets are on sale now.
Tickets are on sale.
So you can get them.
Christmas is coming.
Yes.
So it's October now, so.
Ooh, Christmas shopping.
Yeah, that's right.
There you go. It's a great gift.
Yeah.
An early Christmas gift. And and if you don't get in the Christmas spirit after going to this show, you definitely will be in the Christmas spirit.
And also, that's the same weekend we announced the lineup for the Berks 29th Annual Boscov Berks Jazz Fest.
Ooh, just even that.
Yeah.
You'll want to come. So we thank you, John, again for being with us tonight.
Thank you, Meggan. It was great.
Yeah, and thank you all for watching the Berks Arts Council on BCTV. We'll see you next month.
Get ready for the second annual Reading Blues Fest, presented by the Berks Arts Council, November 16th through the 18th. Enjoy Booker D. Jones, Ruthie Foster, Ronnie Baker Brooks, Billy Branch, Tommy Castro, Shamika Copeland, John Namath, Clarence Spady, Nick Colleone, Little Ed and the Blues Imperials, Vanessa Collier, Tinsey Ellis, and more. Tickets on sale now for an exciting blues-filled weekend in downtown Reading, PA. For the latest info and for tickets, check out ReadingBluesFest.com.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.